Anybody ever flip tires? Yeah? Okay. This goes back to, you were born to do this, okay? We just have to remember. We have to put you in the right position, and it'll happen naturally. So this setup, I'm going to put her about a foot to a foot and a half away from the tire. Yep, she's going to drop down. Absolutely critical, I want contact with the chest and shoulders against the tire, okay? She's not going to deadlift it. We're not going up, and we're not sliding forward. We're going somewhere in the middle. We're looking for a 45 degrees, okay? The first thing we're going to do is just extend the hip, okay? And you'll notice that her arm angle won't change at all, okay? So she's just going to extend up, down. See what happened here? Nothing, okay? So she just extends that hip. So she's going to do that again. Extend up, just like that. Where's her head going? Where's her head going? Forward. Okay, one of the biggest faults that we see is that as that tire is coming up this way, a person has a tendency to go up this way, okay? And they create distance between themselves and the tire. That's like doing a power clean out here, okay? We don't do that. We keep it in tight. So I want the chest and everything that's up here to stay in contact with the tire at all times, okay? So she's gonna come up, extend the hip and her head. Everything is coming forward. Good, down. Next movement, as she unloads that hip, she's going to take a stutter step. You're going to have to decide which leg is dominant that you want to kick with, okay? She's going to take a stutter step with her left leg, and then she's going to kick it with her right leg. Follow that? When it happens quickly, the tire never slows down. It goes right up and over. Stutter step kick, okay? And it's only at the very last second that she does this. That's only at the last second just to aid in that kick, okay? So let's do one or two reps. I'll kick it back to you. Perfect. Watch that stutter step, big kick. Yep, good. Now, these tires are heavy and they're really tall, okay? So we may have to break it up into two separate movements. It's just like that two-stage and the one-timer, okay? So if we break this thing up, you're just going to put it right in your thigh. All she's going to do is put it right in the thigh, okay? From there, can you take your hands off and relax, okay? That doesn't take much effort. So again, don't hit the panic button. You got to settle down a little bit. From here, the natural tendency is for people to do this and to think that they're going to start pushing the tire over. She's not low enough on it. Okay, so what we're gonna do, I actually want her to get down and get those hands underneath the tire and then drive. You see how easy that is? Easy. You've gotta change the leverage point, okay? So if you can get the tire to your thigh, you should be able to get the tire over. You've done most of the work. All you have to do is get a little bit lower and keep driving up. Now, if she does that again, set it up on your thigh. Okay, right from there, that's perfect, okay? Right in the crease of the hip, takes no effort, she can sit there for a second. She digs in a little deeper. Now let's say it's really heavy, okay? And what's she gonna do? She might have to ratchet it up, and then ratchet it up again, and then ratchet it up again until it comes over, okay? It might take 8 tries. It might take a minute. I'm okay with that. You need to be patient. You need to be patient. Just keep working. Bite off another inch. Get another inch. Get another inch. Keep changing the leverage point until it comes over. Okay? Everybody follow?